get killed for this review. VTubers. There's really nothing left to say at this point. One of the biggest phenomenons in this little weeb community for the past few years, you might like them, you might not. I'm usually iffy about them because the Asian idol industry is fucking horrifying, and it was destined that some VTuber would jump into other industries or express themselves in different mediums. Their influence seeping into something that definitely matters way much more and brings this world tremendous value. Anime music. So yeah, we're talking about the new Mori Calliope album. Mori Calliope, streamer, rapper, reaper, jump king cultist. Compared to her gem mates, she's definitely taking this music thing a lot more seriously. Instead of making a generic pop song every 6 months, in the 1.5 years she's been active, she has put out countless pop rap singles and 2 EPs. Are they good? This is the problem you come across when you talk about anime-like music. Because you need a certain level of cringe endurance to even sit through the whole thing, so I really have no fucking idea if I should recommend this to you. But again, if you're watching this video, you're probably fine with Callie trying really hard to sound like an anime girl. Can we eat Shinigami at your service? And if you get over that, which is easier said than done, I know, and consider this a character, then you can find things to enjoy about it. A few of the songs are really catchy, like Red from Your Mori, End of Life, which is still her best song so far, to be honest. Just don't listen to the first EP unless you want your ears wither of cringe. In summary, she has built up a catalog of sorts throughout her VTubing career, a really mixed and mostly cringe catalog, but she does seem to be improving with every new release. This time though, instead of an early announcement of the project, it was announced like 5 days before the whole thing was out. So I guess no hype needed. Maybe that was a wise choice because this is one of the worst things I've heard in a while. I don't know how to start this. Let's just go track by track. When I first heard the title track, I was kind of surprised, as Callie barely even raps on this and her singing is definitely more tolerable to me than her rapping. Does the beat sound like something you can find in an Osu beat map pack? Yeah, kinda. Besides that one part with violins, that was sick. But the worst part is the chorus. Oh god, why? As I said, I was actually kind of into her singing the verses, and then the chorus kicks in, and she's just not fit for this vocal range at all. I can barely string a few words together, and even I'm like, yeah, I don't know about this one, Chief. Also, she just does this. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck to say to that. On the Life is also 5 minutes long, which is way too long for this kind of songwriting. The mixing too sounds off. It does not feel like the mix was trying to complement Callie's voice at all, which is probably a good thing. Oh, I get it now! She with Gagura sees Callie rippity rapping again. I don't care. Gura's singing is technically sound, but I feel like she doesn't really fit the energy level of the track. Beat is... I guess it's fine, nothing mind-blowing. Overall, I'm just kind of overall, I'm just slightly underwhelmed, because this is supposed to be from a big producer. Dead on Arrival feels like the Grim Reaper's Live Streamer Part 2. I actually like the chorus on this one. It's energetic and cool, it makes you want to jump around like Brockhampton does in every concert. Rest in peace, by the way. But the production, Jesus Christ. The guy making the song must think that more sounds, more stuff, louder stuff equals a better and more cohesive track. No! Bro, that's not how music works! But even with my gripes, it's probably one of the better tracks on here. That's really sad to say. Graveyard Shift with Boogie Vox, a Halloween anthem. Generic flow, I can't really speak on Japanese rap, so I won't. The beat does sound a lot better than Dead on Arrival, and it incorporates the Halloween elements pretty well, although it's pretty basic. But then the chorus...
What the fuck is this shit?
Smiling through the lose-lose day sounds even more like an anime opening and a really generic one. I actually physically laughed out loud because of how cliche the song is. We'll use the power of friendship. Huge W. I know it's a gimmick song, but it's still obnoxious as fuck. Sometimes Callie has catchy vocal refrains, and it is hilarious to see Callie say for the first time. But yeah, even more overproduced garbage beat. I do not want to listen to this ever again. Resting Power, produced by Pretty Patterns, the same person who did End of Life, Callie's best song, and I will fight you on this. Probably my favorite out of this entire album. It's melodic, catchy, the beat is simple, but it's just rich enough to be an absolute bop. Even the chorus is great. Callie just sounds herself, powerful and convincing. Scuffed up age, where have the catchy refrains gone? Japanese? Why?
Anime!
Yeah. And manga!
The song feels like a billion songs attached together, and not in a fun way like that one trap song with like 20 beat switches. It just feels messy as shit, on top of being overproduced with these garbage synths
they
love using for some reason. I guess this is Callie's attempt to recreate the Mushoku Tensei opening. just with really stupid singing. He's still rocking the high-pitched sound that's so anime, even I'm kind of repulsed by it. I swear to God, this shit just feels like they said, "Hey, Callie, what's the highest note you can sing?" And Callie's like, In conclusion, this album sucks ass. Because one, the experimentation with her vocals are terrible. Two, horrible production choices all around. And three, everything that's not actively annoying being so bland, it's actually kind of sad. That's all I want to say. I need to listen to that new Denzel Curry album to cleanse my ears. Also, I think Callie should collab with Demon Dice Karen. They seem to have great chemistry. More episode 3 on Trash Taste when?